How would you use gummy bears to rob a bank?
I've got pass them over. I need to look at them.
I thought you might. I might just take a handful myself. Yeah, because I happen to be rather partial. Yeah, aren't they good?
What I would do is sneak up behind the bank clerks and push them into their eyes. Well, they couldn't, you know, on a hot, perhaps on a hot day, so they couldn't actually peel them off. Right, I just go rifle through the drawers, get them.
Any other thoughts?
It's a simple bribery.
There's not much people wouldn't do for
give
a gummy
me the money.
Bear.
No, gummy bear.
Bring them to life and use them as a tiny jelly army.
I want to see that.
If you stuck them all over your face, they could be a brilliant disguise, because you'd just look like an idiot with lots of sweet stuff. They'd never suspect you.
It would be called bare-faced cheek, wouldn't it?
Yes. They, they made...
Sorry.
Can you use them as some kind of plastic explosives? Are they in that family?
It's well, not gelignite, but what are they made of?
Gelatin.
Gelatin, yeah. If you melt them down...
You can make a whale.
A Japanese cryptographer, whose name is Tsutomu Matsumoto, has found that he can fool 80% of all fingerprint detectors using a fake finger made from gummy bears. You get someone's finger and you dip it in the mould material and you make a mould, then you pour the gelatin into the mould and you've got yourself a little gummy finger.
You do that when you go to America now, they make you do that.
Yes, they do.
So you've got to get the bank manager to put his finger in your gum first.
That was his first thing. Obviously, he was doing it as an experiment, but he's discovered with the same rate of success, all he has to do is just take someone's fingerprint photographed off glass, and he can make a gummy finger. So there, an unwilling person.
You can use a monkey.
Well...
Fingerprints.
Well, they have, but you have to have the fingerprints that are recognised by the machine. So the monkey that runs that particular company that you want to get into, obviously. Or what would happen though if you worked in the pineapple industry?
Free pineapples.
You would get free pineapples, but can you think of anything related to your fingerprints and pineapples?
Well, they're quite spiky.
They are spiky. That's true.
The pineapple is the only fruit to have fingerprints.
It has an enzyme, which is called bromelain, because they're bromeliads, aren't they, pineapples? And bromelain actually erases and destroys the fingerprints of people who work with pineapples. It was used as a plot point in an episode of Hawaii 5-0, would you believe?
Episode 1, I should think.
Yeah.
Really pineapples would be very good if you've got mouth ulcers, so that would... I assume, be the same sort of process. Seizing up your mouth ulcers, removing your fingerprints.
Proteolysis, it's called, which is the eating of proteins by enzymes, the digestion of them.
So if I left my fingers in a tin of pineapple rings overnight, I could become a master criminal by morning.
It's perfectly possible.
You just have 5 pineapple chunks. What are you doing? I'm preparing for the raid.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.